Hi students, today we will deal with the 9th chapter, the bond of love. Just have a look at the name, standard 9, chapter 9, the bond of love, part 1. This lesson, there are two parts, as the video is little longer, so we have two parts to do it. So let us start with the story. This story is actually connected to animals and humans. There is always some doubt other than the normal pet like a dog, cat, parrot. Will other animals also can mingle with the human beings? So the answer is this lesson. One experiment or one experience of a person is explained to you, which is a true story or which was a true story. So let us start. The author gets a baby bear by chance. The bond of love is the story of love and friendship between a pet bear cub and the author's wife. He got the bear cub for her by accident. So here, the writer is telling, the narrator itself, the one who experienced, is telling, he got the bear cub. The baby bear, he got it by an accident. It is not that he wanted to go and purchase or he wanted to collect and give it to his wife or something like that. By accident, some accidental thing, incident, he got it. He bought it in the home and it was brought up in the home. So how did he get it? That is what is going to be in the next slide. 2 years ago, they were passing through the sugarcane field near Mysore. People were driving away wild pigs from their fields. Some were shot dead and others escaped. It is usual that wherever agriculture fields, which is stretching far away or far, far distance, usually wild animals like rabbits, pigs will come and eat all these crops. And usually the farmers will drive them away, make them to go away by making sound, by bursting crackers, or even by doing fencing. But fencing is not possible in bigger areas. So what do? Either they put the crackers and burst it, make big sounds, or they shoot them. Oh, it was a usual system which was taking place earlier. Even now in some part of the India, this system is there. So they were shooting the wild pigs to run away. While shooting, some of the wild pigs died and some escaped. Then where does this bear cub come? The bear cub, from where did it came? Let us see the actual incident. Suddenly a sloth bear came out of the field. The author didn't want to shoot at her, but one of his companions shot the bear on the spot. So they were shooting actually the wild pig. The author has gone to Mysore in his field along with the friends, and somebody was shooting many things. Some wild pigs died, some ran away. In between, all of a sudden, there came a sloth bear. A normal black, a big size bear come out. Author never thought of shooting at the bear and kill it, because bear will not spoil the crops much. By walking it may spoil a little bit, but by eating nothing they will do. He did not want, but in between the group or among the group, somebody suddenly took the gun and shot. Even the bear died there. They were a little worried. Naturally, all ran to the dead body to see and see what happens there. They came near the fallen animal. They saw a baby bear riding on its mother's back. The little bear ran around the dead body of its mother. He was making a pitiful noise. Then he ran away into the sugarcane field. So all these people, the group of people, ran to the dead body of this bear. Wild pig, they of course they know, but this is the first time they are seeing a bear dead. So they came near to that. Then they saw there was a baby bear, a cub was there. The cub was moving around. By the time it saw so many people coming to its mother's body, it ran inside the sugarcane field. So in the textbook, there is a word used, scooted. It scooted into the sugarcane field. Scooted means ran away into the sugarcane field for hiding. Then what happened? At last, the other was able to catch him. The little bear struggled to free himself. He tried to scratch him with his long hooked claws. So what happened? Even they started searching. Where is this baby bear? All together they started going here and there, and among the field they started going behind it. It also started running, but it became tired. Finally, other caught it. When the other caught it by the neck and lifting it up, it tried to escape by moving like this. With the long claws, it tried to scratch, but somehow the other managed, and he took it in his car and took it to Bangalore where he was living. They put him in a gunny bag. They brought him to Bangalore. The author presented the little creature to his wife. She was really delighted. The cub was a male. She named it Bruno. Very simple to understand. The author bought this cub in a bag and brought it to Bangalore, where was his house, and he gave a present, as a present to his wife. The wife was so happy. Everybody get puppies, cats, kittens, all that is usual thing. But getting a bear cub, that was a small one, she was so delighted. They checked it, it was a male baby. So they named it as Bruno. Again in the textbook, you can see a word called christened. They christened it Bruno. Christened it means in the name of Jesus Christ. They gave the name Bruno to the baby. How the baby bear is brought up. The author's wife looked after the baby bear like her own child. Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. As usual, author's wife started taking care of it. Within no days, it learned how to drink milk from the bottle. It's a wild animal. It was drinking the milk of his mother. Now his mother is dead. So they started giving the milk. Within few days, it started learning how to drink milk from the bottle. And also, he started eating and drinking a lot of things. He ate porridge, vegetables, fruit, nut, meat, rice, eggs, etc. He drank tea, milk, coffee, and even beer and liquor. And this baby bear was not an ordinary one. It was a little naughty and mischievous one. It was ready to eat anything, drink anything. No problem. Give tea, he will drink. Give cold drinks, he will drink. You give him alcoholic drink, that also. No problem. Literally everything it started eating and drinking. Now, in the next slide, it is told how he was spending the time. They had two Alsatian dogs. The baby bear became friendly with the dogs and all the children. He spent his time in playing and running into the kitchen. He also slept in their beds. How he was spending the time? He was playing with all the kids around that. In Bangalore, it is a city, there will be people around them. In fact, in the author's house, some tenants were also living. Rented people in the adjoining building or adjoining rooms. Rented people also were living, tenants. They were also having kids. Author also was having some kids. All became friendly with it. And also, author's two Alsatian dogs. Alsatian dogs, you would have seen it. Like that, they were having two Alsatian dogs. This bear became friendly with them within no time. So he played with that. He started moving here and there, going to kitchen, going everywhere, eating something, playing with them, and also sometimes coming and sleeping in their bed also, like any other pet. So it was spending most of the time with the family members only. A strange incident. One day, an accident befell him. The author had put down rat poison, barium carbonate, in the library to kill rats. Bruno entered the library and ate some of this poison. Here is the word, barium carbonate. It is a scientific name of rat poison. So, the author is telling one incident which is little important in the life of Bruno. While he was growing up, he was little naughty, mischievous. So he used to eat everything what he is getting. Owner has put some rat poison in his library where rats are coming and spoiling the books. The rat poison was nothing other than barium carbonate. Any animal, including human beings, if it is taken inside, your nervous system will get spoiled. So, as usual, Bruno moved here and there, finally it entered there, it saw something is there kept. It was not knowing it was rat poison, it took eight. So, naturally, you can imagine what would have happened. I told, barium carbonate, when you are eating, your nervous system will start damaging, and within no time, maybe within half an hour, 1 hour, that person will die. That is why rat poison some people are taking and eating and suiciding. You would have heard about that. Some people are taking pesticide, drinking and suiciding. So these things are very toxic. So the rat poison was taken by Bruno by mistake without knowing whether it was a rat poison or not. And actually this was kept in library where he never used to go. But that day it was open. Nobody took care. He went, ate. So what happens next? He suffered from a stroke of paralysis. But he dragged himself slowly to the author's wife. He was weakening rapidly. He was vomiting and breathing heavily. The effect of the poison started. He got a sudden stroke, sudden shake. His body became weak, body movement became very dull, or is not able to move also. Somehow, with his willpower, he dragged in four legs or somehow dragged his body. Instead of walking or going, the author is using the word, he dragged. On the floor, he dragged himself to the author's wife where she was in the kitchen or somewhere. From the library, he came out to get the attention of someone. By the time, he was becoming weak, weak, weak. He started vomiting and started breathing like this, heavily. Then what happened? Suddenly, other people understood something has happened. He has taken something wrong. So let us see what is that. Taken to a veterinary surgeon. He was taken to a veterinary surgeon and 10 cubic centimeter of antidote was given to him. His condition remained unchanged. Another 10 cc was injected. So the author's wife called the author in the office. He called a veterinary surgeon and they took the medicine and came. And the medicine was an antidote for barium carbonate. Antidote means whenever you are taking some poisonous things by mistake, to neutralize that, what chemical you are putting inside the body is called antidote. Here also, some antidote for the barium carbonate was given by the doctor. First, 10 cubic centimeter. 10 cubic centimeter means 10 ml, milliliter. They waited, no changes. Again, doctor took one more chance, gave one more 10 ml. Let us see what will happen. Will that poison neutralize and the beer will come back or not? Because it is already paralyzed, vomiting, breathing is become very heavy for him and is almost in the brink of the death. What happens? Let us see. After some time, Bruno got up and enjoyed a good meal. Another time, the little bear drank a gallon of old engine oil, but it had no ill effects whatever on him. After giving the first dot or first dose, no change occurred. The doctor gave second dose. Within no time, some changes started. He started moving the body. Within half an hour, he got up, started eating, and he started eating as if nothing has happened to him. Half an hour before, he was going to die. One injection, waited, no change. Second injection, again they waited, some movements started. Within another 10-15 minutes, he got up and he started eating good amount of food as if some dinner or something is there. And he started looking everyone disdainfully. He's looking everybody as if, what happened? What is this bearing carbonate for me? Nothing. Like that. This is the incident the author is specifying in the life of Bruno. Another incident is telling that from the car, the engine oil was removed and kept in order to apply where these termites are moving. Usually everyone does. Old engine oil, if you apply on the place where the termites are there, the termites will die. So for that purpose, from the car, engine oil was kept in a bottle or in a container. One day, Bruno took that and drank also. But that didn't affect him much, like barium carbonate E8. So like this, doing some naughty things, some risky things, like any other pet animal, the Bruno also started growing up. Let us see what the author is saying about him. So, in this manner, the author is explaining that how the Bruno was brought up in his home, or how his wife was taking care of him, and from two accidents or a serious accident of eating barium carbonate, how Bruno was coming out. That is what is explained in the first part. But the Bruno is growing up. As it is growing, and you know, a bear will become a big in size. No person can keep a bear in a normal house in order to maintain him or in order to keep him as a pet. Because the size of the bear, you know it. So what happens in the future life of Bruno, he is explaining in the next video. So, till that, we will explain that part in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.